Hey guys, it's Julie and
Claire,
and we're at home just like you are. We miss you guys. We hope you're doing well. We wanted to tell you about something coming up next Sunday. It's going to be called
Easter Jam.
Easter Jam, and it's an experience for the whole family. So it's not just for you kids. It's for moms, dads, kids, grandparents, whoever. So we wanted to tell you about that ahead of time because there's a few things you're going to need for next Sunday. So, the first thing you're going to need are
peeps.
So, you're going to need peeps, and with those peeps, you're going to need some toothpicks. And so, you'll learn more about why that is on Sunday, next Sunday. You're also going to need laundry basket and some socks. So, you're going to need about 10 to 20 pairs of socks. We don't care if they're clean or not, whatever you want to do, okay? This Sunday is a special Sunday. It's called Palm Sunday. So Palm Sunday is when Jesus rode a donkey into Jerusalem. Ah, we got a donkey right here. And as Jesus was riding the donkey into Jerusalem, people were waving palm branches at him. And Jesus knew why he was going to Jerusalem. He was going to Jerusalem to change the world forever. And so we're going to learn more about that next week on Easter Sunday, about how Jesus changed the world forever. So because it's a new month, it's the first Sunday in April, we have new memory verses. The first memory verse is for preschoolers. So if you're a preschooler, I want you to stand up and do this memory verse with me, okay? It says, I am alive forever and ever. Revelation 1:18. I am alive forever and ever. Revelation 1:18. So we're going to do some motions with that. We're going to put our hands up. We're going to say, I am alive. And then forever and ever, we're going to spin around. Ready? Forever and ever. And then we're going to open our Bible. Revelation 1:18. And Jesus is alive forever and ever. And we're going to learn more about that next week at Easter time. Okay? If you are an elementary school, if you're kindergarten through fifth grade, this month's theme is upside down, just like Claire. So upside down is the theme because Jesus turned things upside down for the world. He said and he did things that people didn't think he should say or do, and he turned things upside down. He did things differently than people expected. So our memory verse for this month, if you'll take a look up here, I don't know if you can see it that well or not, but it says, don't do anything only to get ahead. Don't do it because you're proud. Instead, be humble. Value others more than yourselves. And that's from Philippians 2:3. Okay? So we're going to say that one more time with you guys. Don't do anything to get ahead. Don't do it because you are proud. Instead, be humble, value others more than yourselves. And that's exactly what Jesus did. He valued you and he valued me more than himself. He died on the cross for my sins and for your sins. And he did things upside down. He did things differently than the world expected. Okay, so next, guys, your parents are going to show you the videos for this week. So if you scroll down in this email, you'll see something that says Bible videos, and there's videos for preschoolers, kindergarten through second grade, which will say elementary, and then third through fifth grade, which will say preteen. So watch those videos. After you watch those videos, parents, you can scroll down a little bit further and it'll say parent guides. And so you can click on those and see some activities that you can do after your kids watch the video, as well as some questions you can ask them. If you're in elementary school, if you scroll down a little bit further in the email, you'll see the God Time cards. And those are daily devotionals that are designed for your kids to be in the Word of God at least 4 days a week. And lastly, if you're a preschooler, or a preschool parent, we have a preschool placemat. And so what you can do is click on that link, and the preschool placemat will pop up. You can print that out, and I would suggest covering it with contact paper or laminating it if you have access to a laminator. and your kid can use that throughout the month. If you need us to print off any of these things, if you want us to print off the preschool play mat and laminate it for you, we'd be glad to. Just contact me and we will get that done for you. We hope you guys are doing well. We miss you so much and we love you guys. Bye.